Crayon Queen Donna Summer had everyone dancing to her beat. But behind the music, there was enough tragedy and pain to lead to an attempt to take her own life. Donna tells all to Mary Hart.
Donna? Oh my gosh, good luck.
You're still doing this after all these years?
I thought that's what I was going to ask you.
Donna became the queen of disco over 30 years ago, but at the height of her fame, she was perched on a window in her New York apartment, ready to throw herself to her death.
You talked about it reaching a point where you were suicidal.
It sort of snuck up on me, and I think it came because I had my daughter, and during that period, my marriage broke up, and I was alone, and I was staying up at night, and I would go out and work, and then I'd be up with her, and maybe getting 2 or 3 hours of sleep a day.
That's scary.
It was scary. And I just couldn't deal with another minute of it. And I was on my way out the window. I was sticking my foot out. I was shifting my weight, and I got caught in the curtain, and the maid opened the door at exactly that time. I was literally shifting my weight. And I was looking at the curtain, and then I heard the chain rattle on the door, and I looked over, and I saw the maid looking at me. And I thought, oh my God, you know, and it really kind of shook me. It woke me up. And then I went to, I said, wait a minute, I'll let you in. And then I let her in, and I got on the phone, and I think I called someone. I said, I think I need help. And thank God that lady came, because I'd be gone today.
That's horrifying to hear.
Yeah, it was
very scary.
You know, I think the worst thing is that I didn't realize I was even doing it at the time. It was as though I was in a daze. You know, and I think afterwards I was on medication for about 2 years, and then I got off the medication, and I've been off it ever since.
Between 1978 and 1984, there would be 10 top 5 hits, 4 of them topping the charts. She would win 4 Grammys and sing this Oscar-winning song.
After you get those things, and they're just sort of sitting there in the room, and you're thinking, okay, what next? My next goals were personal. They were have my family. Let's get on with your real life.
That she did. She has 3 daughters, including Brooklyn, now 27, and is a grandmother of 3, and she's quickly approaching the big 6-0.
How about, like, kissing it?
Welcome, 60!
Hello, sweetie!
And she says her fans better get used to it.
It's really hard being a diva these days. And that, you know, they have to learn to let me grow older and let me grow gracefully, because I don't plan on having 900 facelifts to please them. And so
they get it.
Donna achieved stardom at a young age, so she has some thoughts on what young stars are doing now, like the whole Miley Cyrus flap over the photos in Vanity Fair out now.
It's difficult. What do you tell your kids? This is not appropriate behavior for my granddaughter. I wouldn't want her taking those pictures at her age.
Donna had battles over her image early in her career too.
It happened to me in the beginning of my career, where it was sexified, and it was difficult because I was fighting not being that way, because it wasn't that accepted back then, and they were pushing me to be that way, and I kept going, why can't I just be who I am, you know? And it was a big struggle, and they kept pushing me more towards that, and I kept edging my way back this way, and I think eventually over the course of 2 or 3 years, I kind of put my foot down and said, that's it, I'm not doing that anymore.
Sexy or not, she wowed audiences with her music for many decades, but Donna found she didn't want to just live in the past.
Well, I was sitting at home on the couch watching TV, eating potato chips, fast becoming a desperate housewife, as I say on stage, which is my onstage life. And I thought, you know, is this going to be the rest of my life? Is this all there is? I mean, I can't do this forever. I'll be like this big and that wide, and I've got to find a day job.
So on May 20th, you'll get brand new Donna Summer music. Stamp Your Feet is the single from Crayons, Donna's first new album in 17 years. It's full circle for Summer. She collaborated with songwriter Evan Bogart, son of the late Neil Bogart, the music mogul who discovered Donna.
You literally have known him since he was born, right?
Before he was born.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
When I was a child, his mother's stomach.
It made recording a very emotional time.
I almost started crying in the room because it was just like this whole emotional thing on top of it. I'm like, I'm working with, I almost started crying now, with Neil's son.
Still brings back a
lot of emotion. Yeah.
Okay. Give me Kleenex quick.
Now, Mary Hart and a very special guest right here on our Stage 28.
Joining us now, the icon who brought the house down on American Idol, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Donna Summer. Donna, it's so good to have you on our stage.
Thank you.
How did it feel last night in front of that audience?
Well, it was exciting. Oh, it's so exciting. I can't even tell you. Audience full of the celebrities and the kids screaming their heads off. It's fantastic.
And Donna gives her seal of approval to Idol winner David Cook. This is the time of my life. Do you have any advice for David?
Yes, get a good lawyer. That's the first advice, and save his money. I've been wrong
so many times before. You have such a great single out right now. It's what you performed last night on Idol. How does it feel to already have a hit back on the charts?
Incredible. Incredible. I haven't had any sleep in days.
When do you start touring?
I start touring July the 5th.
I know you have performed it only last night.
Yep.
And you're going to do it for us right now. You ready to sing?
Are you singing background?
You know what? I'll be singing background out there,
okay?
I get to watch you. You ready to sing?
I'm ready to sing.
Super!
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Donna Summer and Stamp Your Feet!
Something else.